A major part of the surface water improvement project is filtering that needs to be in place to meet new federal requirements. Testing is taking place right now on membrane filtration technology that will be an important part of the new surface water delivery system.
Well, HDR is running this pilot test up here at the Outback facility of a small-scale water treatment plant, and we're optimizing the city's investment in the new water filtration facility and also reducing the operation and maintenance for the new facility. Well, this is a test facility, and the machine behind me filters the water just like the larger water treatment plant will do in the future. Well, this is the membrane filtration module that's made by Asahi Corporation in Japan. It's a sophisticated system that's a module and includes these small fibers that do the filtration. The water flows from the outside of these fibers to the inside. The purified water goes inside the fiber and exits out this end, while the dirt and the organisms that we're concerned about stay on the outside of the fiber and get removed from the city's water supply.
The testing of this filtration system is an inexpensive way to make sure that we're making the right purchase in the whole filter system.
Well, today we were able to show staff and council the layout of the pilot test here for demonstrating the performance of the membrane filter. We also took a look around the site and were able to take a look at the site layout. And one of the benefits of this project is that we're going to eliminate taking water out of the creek that then overflows back to the creek downstream. So that water will actually be left in with the new project.
My impression of visiting the membrane filtration pilot project that we've got going on right now is that, you know, it's a very sophisticated, really great use of technology to supply clean water to the city.
Well, with this project, we'll install a pretreatment system, which will include a concrete tankage with mixers and the settling basin at the south end of this Outback site. And then there'll also be a building which houses the membrane filters and pumping and piping associated with the membrane filters. It's just about 15,000 square feet.
The city is spending a large amount of money on filtering the water through a membrane treatment system. It's important that we get it right. And this pilot project allows us to test it, make changes as necessary before we purchase the system in a few years.
During the early summer, the city's water demands are increasing as irrigation is increasing in town. And currently, there's too much turbidity in the water during that snowmelt season that occurs at the same time. Once filtration's installed, the city will be able to access that water to provide water to the city from surface water and to provide a less expensive source than pumping from deep underground.
Well, when you're making decisions that are multi-million dollar decisions, it's really helpful to see what we're talking about and to see that this filter that we're buying looks like it's gonna work. Right now I feel really good about it.
Well, if the council approves the hydropower project in August of this year, then a hydropower project would also be installed and it would be associated with the pretreatment basin here at the Outback site. Well, the next steps are to complete the level of design based on the results of this pilot test. And we're working with the contractor to do the bidding for the project. And at that time, the construction could commence in year 2012.